So again, our topic is, does Christianity harm women, and is there a problem with women in the new atheist movement? Karen gave the pro, or the affirmation of that, saying, yes, Christianity does harm women, and yes, there is a problem with women in the new atheist movement, and so I'm going to give a con position to that. My name is Bernie Daler. I have a booklet that I wrote that's for sale on Amazon. It's called Modern Science and Philosophy Destroy Christian Theology. I'm a former evangelical Christian preacher. I used to preach the gospel on TV, and now I'm preaching atheism. So, and I'm also very active in local Portland area debates on Christianity and atheism, and so on my YouTube channel you can see a whole bunch of those. Okay, so now I'll start. Okay, so on the handout you can see I've got a picture there. It's kind of funny. It says, women are not decorations, and it shows some other women from Hooters there. And so this is kind of interesting because I'm going to bring this up later, but some women think how you dress is very important, and it could be a feminist issue. So this kind of shows maybe, you can see the woman in the tight clothes kind of looking perplexed at the other one with the sign. So this is kind of interesting even among women. So I'm going to bring up some definitions just for clarification here. Okay, so first, what is feminism? So feminism, in my view, I'm just trying to say it's very clear and simple. It's just that women deserve equal rights with men. And some women don't like that word feminism, or some guys, because I think it's radical and it's very pro-women at the expense of hurting guys, and so they think a better word is egalitarianism, which seems that basically means that men and women are equal. But that word could actually mean more of humanity, that, you know, all races and people are equal, so it's more than just men and women. So I think feminism really is a good way to express equal rights for women as a term. It's just that it's got a lot of bad baggage, and so some people don't like to be called a feminist. You can call me a feminist because I fully support equal rights for women. Misogyny is a word to mean that, you know, it's a woman hater. So sometimes, you know, if a guy says, oh, all women are stupid, that's a misogynist statement. And then also some women may hate guys, and that's called misandry. So basically, if a woman says all guys are stupid, that's showing hatred for guys. So just to give an example here, I looked on the internet here, and Augustine was a bishop, a very famous bishop for both Catholics and Protestants. They, you know, for example, he wrote the book, he's noted as one of the church fathers, and wrote The City of God and Confessions. He's very well known with philosophers too. Basically, here's a quote from him. This is a misogyny example. Woman was merely man's helpmate, a function which pertains to her alone. She is not the image of God, but as far as man is concerned, he is by himself the image of God. So very clearly, men and women are not equal there. Woman is merely man's helpmate, and the image of God is on men only, not on women. So how are guys put down by women? Some people have said that, well, if you look at a lot of modern sitcoms, for example, it's very common to make fun of guys, like Homer Simpson, for example, is a stupid, goofy guy. You don't really see sitcoms with stupid women, although Married with Children has kind of a stupid guy and a stupid woman, but mostly it's a stupid guy in there, I think, too. But, you know, like Beavis and Butthead is another example, and somebody else said, everyone loves Ray. Yeah, they love him, but he's kind of a doofus, too, sometimes. And so that may be an example of how men are put down in modern culture. So my next one here, I show a slide of three ways that women can dress. And I want to show this to explain some extremes. On the one hand, you have people saying women should be covered head to toe in a bag. You know, that's the burqa. And then on the other extreme, you might say, hey, women can wear nothing. This, the one on the right, she's wearing body paint. You know, so she's basically naked. And I don't know, she could probably walk around in public and get away with that, I would think. And then in the middle there, you got your gray area. It's like, well, it's just wearing clothes. It's no big deal. So women, or guys even, they could argue about what's the appropriate way to dress. The woman on the right wearing just body paint, somebody could say, that's very demeaning to women. I'm a feminist, and this is appalling to me. Well, I would say this really has nothing to do with feminism. This has to do more with what's socially acceptable. So I think this is one way how feminism could be misconstrued, because it doesn't really apply here. But on the other hand, you know, wearing the bag, you can say this is a feminist issue, because You know, women shouldn't have to be covered in a bag. But, you know, another argument might be, well, what if the woman wants to be covered? Well, maybe she just needs to be liberated in her mind as well, though. She needs to know what equality is, and it's healthier to not be wearing a bag, you know. Because why she want to be in a bag anyway? It's probably because of the religion that has polluted their mind in that thinking. Maybe, you know, because they're taught that guys can't control their lusts and we need to help them by covering up. Okay, so now let's get to the main question. Does Christianity harm women? And so I kind of have a yes and a no on this. So basically, one of my first points is, what is a Christian? I think it's important to say that we need to respect people. If they say they're a Christian, we need to accept that. We can't say, no, you don't believe the right thing, so you're not a Christian. There's the no true Scotsman fallacy where, you know, if you say all true Scotsmen do this, and somebody says, well, here's a Scotsman over here that doesn't do that, and you could say, well, that's not a true Scotsman. So in the same way, I don't think we should be in the position of saying, what's a true Christian? If somebody says a Christian, they're a Christian, that's good enough for me. I'm going to bring that up later to show that not all Christians have a problem with women. Okay, but, you know, for sure, the largest denomination by far is Roman Catholicism. Now, there's more Protestants than Catholics in America, but they're fractured across different denominations. So if you just go by denomination, by far the biggest group is Roman Catholicism. Of course, they've got all kinds of troubles with women. I mean, the top guy's a pope. You're never going to see a woman pope. They have a priest and a nun system, and nuns, you know, women can't be priests, and I think nuns are lower in hierarchy than the priests. So there's obvious problems with that. So there are, and you know, the Catholic Church does not like to change, and so that's not going to be changing anytime soon. So there are obvious issues with feminism in some Christian religions. But the question is it all Christians? Do all Christians have a problem with feminism? So when I was a Christian I was a Christian for many years. I went through many different denominations. My last denomination was what you might call evolutionary creationist, where I totally accepted all of science. And I had no issue with women. I had no problem with women. Now, people in this camp, usually they say, you know, it's all about a relationship with Jesus. You pray to Jesus and you have a relationship with Jesus. And that's the biggest thing. And you can read the Bible for good stuff out of it, and if there's something bad in there, don't let it worry you. You know, someday you go to heaven and that'll get all worked out, but you know, if there's something you don't understand, just don't worry about it. So there are people like that I think totally have no problem with women whatsoever. So because of that, you cannot say that all Christians and all Christian sects, all Christian denominations have a problem with women, I think. But I would certainly agree, maybe most of them do, or the vast majority of them do. Okay, so, and you know, also women, probably Protestants and Catholics have a problem with women in leadership. You know, the head pastor cannot be a woman, for example. But, you know, when you consider the Foursquare Church as an evangelical church, I mean, that was actually started by a woman. So there's no way you can say they would probably have a problem with women equality. I think they have full liberation for women. As far as I know, they don't have any limits on what women can do. And so I would say maybe the more Pentecostal the Christian group is, the more freedom there is on that. So bottom line, I would say, is there a problem with Christianity? Yes. But not all of them. Now, is there a problem for women in the New Atheism movement? I would say there's no problems with women and feminism in the atheist movement whatsoever. But there is a lot of gossip going around. Has anybody heard of Elevator Gate with Rebecca Watson? Are you guys familiar with that? Okay. Just briefly, what happened was Rebecca Watson, she goes by Skeptic. She was in an elevator at 4 in the morning going to her room after a conference, and a guy said, hey, don't take this wrong, but you know, I really like what you said. Would you like to come to my room for coffee? And she said, listen, guys, don't do that. That is, you know, it was very bad in all this. And so then Richard Dawkins said, hey, you know, you think that's abusive or something, you need to get out more. I mean, Muslims are really getting, you know, tortured over this, and here you are, you know, complaining about this, come on. And so they just went back and forth, and so Dawkins is a really bad guy, and, you know, they just amped it up and left it at that. Another case is, have you guys heard of Michael Shermer's rape dispute. So somebody said he date raped a girl, basically, and this never went to court or anything. So people are talking about this in the gossip arena, and it gets very emotional. So, but the bottom line is, it's all about gossip. If you look at the big picture for feminism, I mean, we can see where it's gotten us. It's, you know, the right to vote for women, the right to education, the right to work, equal pay for equal work, right to birth control, abortion was made safer. So in America, I think, you know, feminism has really gone a lot, so far, maybe it's not really much even an issue now for most Americans, and now we've elevated it to human rights and even animal rights. Okay, so I'll just finish up here. But in summary, I would have to say that there is no problem with anti-feminism. There's no problem with women in the atheist movement because there's nothing in it that says women are inferior and shouldn't be doing things. And in fact, I think they're actually probably actively reaching out for women in conferences and things like that. So that's my position. So now we'll have some interchange, about 5 minutes for me to question you, and then 5 minutes for you to question me.